Constructed for your sons and me. Thought-filled life. was a king who lived in a castle by the sea. He married a queen, lovely and kind, and they were as happy can be. She came from a city beneath the sea, ruled by a rival who sought her hand. To the king and his queen were born two boisterous boys, and all the bells rang, joyous, happy, pealing throughout the land. But down in the deep, the bell summons the sea's giant tide to rise from its sleep, to rise from its sleep and climb the sky wide. Isn't it strange? At the height of summer, I would expect you to be closest to Earth. At your perihelion, and not as you are. At your thank you. some silly things. Sometimes the scientist in me irritated your romantic brain. W and X over Y equals Z. I say science is a systematic enterprise, building and organizing knowledge in the form of testable explanations and predictions about the universe. And you threw your pillow at me. You said calculus, theorems, triangulations. Where's the humanity? I said, humanity is an end of itself. Every other end, be it A, B, or C, is valuable because of its relation to it. And that includes happiness. Oh, the things you talk about when you're in love and lying together in bed of a morning. Then I continued. Science can prove and disprove, explain, calculate, demonstrate with precision the making of the universe. The supposition, the distance to the stars above, the origin and evolution of the world below. You asked, and love, what about love? And I answered, it's like happiness, a chemical response. Three main neurotransmitters are involved: adrenaline, dopamine, and serotonin. And then you... endothermic pyrolysis to produce gaseous fuel. Into your arms you took me, Dulled not a passion. Children, allowed us to fashion a life out of love. I still catch my breath at the determination of joy. Thank you. the days grow cold, but still a beauty of winter's red roses. What was that? Who wants to see me? Even though I imprison myself in my garden, your love. Memory is pitiless. It knocks at my door and opens it. The earth becomes a desolate sea. It was that day. We went sailing. Charles, the older son. Harry, the younger one. Nothing to warn us that this time would be different. That day on the sea, was perfect, the sky clear and bright, and then the white squall came into sight, and we were fighting for our lives. Suddenly the sail snapped. I told you, we're not going to make it. You answered. I have my faith. I believe. Should we die, we will go to him. I told you, life is just a 20-foot fountain of energy operating in the brain. And you laughed. It's just like you to think of science at a time like this. And because I love you, at the height of the storm, I conceded. One of the surest axioms of science is that energy never dies. It never dies. And even Einstein, on his deathbed, wanted to. Was swamped, merciless the sea. My wife and Harry flung from the deck into the water, out of reach, out of reach, out of reach, out of reach. Were frightened. Help us, Daddy! A father is supposed to look after his family. Forgive me, Harry. Forgive me. Forgive me. be treated. Retreated. Even from Charles. Charles, though he needed me greatly, needed me. Left a note. I'm going to join Mommy and Harry. You loved Harry more than me, anyway. The supreme principle of morality must be purely formal. Humanity exists as an end in itself. once was a king who lived in a castle by the sea. He lost his queen and his two sons, and now lives in exile away from the sea. Away from the siren songs, away from the memories, away from his queen and her princes, where deep in cold beds of coral they do lie.
Calculus for death.